I'm Micah Smith. In this video, we're going to take a look at an intro to package development. This is kind of like the pre-work that we have to do before we can actually jump into developing packages. And this is specifically about machine setup. So you want to make sure that your environment is set up so that as we get into the package development, you'll actually be able to follow along with me, that you'll be able to build the package with me, and you'll be able to, you know, kind of build along as we're going. So hang with me on this one. We're gonna set up our machines just to make sure we've got everything in place so that when we get to building, it should go smoothly. So I wanna cover exactly what we need to get things set up. If you have some of this stuff installed already and configured already, you can obviously skip that part, but I wanna talk through it so we explain it, and then I'll show what it looks like on a totally clean machine. So first off, we will need the JDK 11. This is available for free online. We're gonna be downloading it and installing it from Oracle. But this will allow us to do the development that we need. We also need a Java IDE, and this is the development environment of your choosing. We'll be using Intellij Community Edition for this particular video. You could use NetBeans, you could use Eclipse, something else. I personally really like Intellij, so we'll be using that one for the video. You'll also need Gradle plugin version 5x in the IDE. Eclipse, Intellij, NetBeans are all supported for that, and it's included out of box with Intellij for sure. So that's going to be the easiest path going forward. If you don't have any experience in Java or haven't set that up any previously, I would stick with Intellij to get that set up. But if you want to use any other IDE, just make sure that you have Gradle 5x plugin installed. You'll have to have a bot agent installed. Hopefully that's like pre-work that you've already done. Hopefully you've been doing automation anywhere development before, but you want to make sure that that bot agent is installed so that as we get into testing and as we get into making sure this stuff is set up correctly, that we'll be able to test our own stuff. And finally, we want to make sure we have the package SDK. For this video, we'll be using the .19 version of that package SDK. So I'll show you exactly where to find that. We'll be downloading that together. We'll talk about what's in there, and we'll even compile it just to make sure that everything works correctly with our setup. Cool. So let's switch over to that machine. All right. So I'm on my virtual machine right now. I have a couple windows set up that we're going to use for this process. But the first thing we talked about we have to have is JDK 11. So if you just do a search on Google for JDK 11, the very first link that comes up is the Java SE development kit. This is directly from Oracle. I'm using Windows. I'm using a 64-bit flavor of Windows. So you'll want to download either the Windows 64-bit installer or the Windows 64 compressed archive. Either one of those will work. Obviously, if you're using a different operating system, you can select the appropriate version of JDK 11 for your machine. But I am doing this on Windows, so I'm going to be using that version. So you want to download that one. It will request that you sign in or establish an account with Oracle if you don't have one already. It's worth it just to get this download out of the way. So I downloaded this already, same with the other elements that we're going to look at, but this is the one you want to download if you're using a 64-bit version of Windows like I am. The next thing we want to get is Intellij IDE. So if you go to jetbrains.com/IDEA, that's where you'll find that. I'm going to have all these links in the description and the text below as well. So, you know, you don't have to like try and squint and look at them on my screen. So I will give you all of this, but you'll want to make sure to download this. When you click download here, it's going to take you to a page where you can choose either the ultimate version or the community version. Again, I'm using Windows, so I'm going to select the Windows version. If you're using Mac or Linux, you can select the appropriate versions. I'll be using the community edition for this, so you can download that. It's free. It's their open source version, but support this company for sure. If you want to get their ultimate experience, go for it. I love this tool. I use it quite a bit. So, you know, download whatever version you want. If you want to use a different IDE, again, that's fine. I'm just using Intellij for this particular video. So if you want to use something else, that's totally fine too. So anyway, download that. Like I said, I already downloaded it, so we'll show that installation process. The last part is making sure that we have our SDK. Now, this has some of those same requirements that we just talked about. So if you want to, you know, re-review those, you can go through that. This is from the documentation portal at automationanywhere.com. Again, I'll make this link available for you so that you can come directly here if you need to reference any of this stuff. I'll be using the February 2021 release of this, which corresponds to the .19 version of Automation Anywhere. If you're using an older version of Automation Anywhere Control Room, just make sure that you're using the appropriate SDK version that matches up with your version of the control room, because you might have issues if you try to build it on .19, but then install it and run it on a .17 environment. So it would work the other way. If you had a .17 package that you built, it should install fine on a .19 environment, but you don't want to go the other way. So just, you know, pay attention to what version of the control room you're using, and that way you can see exactly what version of the SDK to download. So again, download this one. So I have, through the magic of video editing, I already have these three components. We're gonna start off with the installation of the JDK. As of right now, I don't have any version of Java installed on this particular machine. So this will be the only version that's gonna be installed there. Hit next, next. This is not gonna be a terribly exciting portion of the video. And I'll probably fast forward right here because no one wants to see my status bar. Okay, so that's been installed. I'm gonna hit close. Again, wasn't a whole lot to that one. I can verify the installation by going to, command prompt. And then I can go to java-version. And here it should show me that I now have Java 11 installed. So good there, I'm gonna close that out. The next thing I'm gonna install is Intellij. So I'm going to right click on this and say run as administrator. Okay. Again, this is gonna be a super unexciting installation. I think it's just next. The one thing I am gonna add is add open folder as project. That's a context menu, so like when you right click, it will allow you to open that directory so that you can open projects directly from the Windows Explorer as opposed to going through the IntelliJ menus. I like to have it there just because I'm using that a lot. That's up to you though. So I'll hit next here. Install, and while that's going, so that I only have to fast forward the video once, I'm also going to extract our SDK right now. So I'll hit extract, and again, I'm just saving these into like a dummy folder on my desktop. You could do this in your downloads directory, whatever you want. Okay, so that's installed. Now, this is the, like I said, I basically did the unzipping of that folder. This is the SDK itself. If I right click here, obviously I can open folder as IntellIJ Community Edition Project. That was that context menu thing I was talking about. If you did not do that, we'll just show how to do it from the start. So I'm gonna go here to IntellIJ, which was my recently installed directory. I'm not going to import any settings. I'm going to copy this directory here, which again, for me, is just my desktop. For you, that could be your downloads directory, wherever you save that SDK to. I'm going to hit open. I'm going to paste that directory in there and hit OK. Okay, so it's starting to open up that project. Notice that it's also, and it's gonna show some tips here. This is just default IntellIJ, you can close that. It's starting to download Gradle. It's also going to look through and download some of the dependencies that are required for this particular SDK. So I'm gonna just expand this because we don't need to see anything else. Again, I'm gonna fast forward through this part. Okay, I'm gonna allow access. This may or may not come up depending on how you have your Windows security settings, but I'm gonna allow access to my private network here. It really shouldn't be needed for this project, but Okay, so Gradle has been installed. We can now come here and take a look at that SDK. I'm gonna minimize this for right now. And I specifically wanna look at the build.gradle file. I just wanna check this before we do any compiling. Remove these. Okay, so one thing I want to point out here, if you've used a previous version of the SDK, you may have noticed that these were previously commented out. These are dependencies that are identified in the build.gradle. They work for the particular actions that have been set up as a part of this basic SDK, which really just shows you how to use different features, right? I mean, they've got everything, like how to do a desktop operation, how to use the different data types, how to actually write a couple basic actions, how to interface with UI, conditional statements, iterators, triggers, and then variable types. So these actually support, I believe it's the triggers themselves. So if you're just gonna try and build the project like I am right now, you wanna leave these enabled. The downside of that is it's gonna make the package a little bit larger. If you're not going to use these, right, if you're just gonna, like we will in a future video, just delete a lot of these sample ones because you don't actually need them, you can also remove these dependencies and you can either delete them or comment them out. But what we're gonna try and do is just build the SDK as it exists. And what that would do is basically create a package for us that is called A2019 Demo Package. And that would enable us to install this on our control room. So we'd have something right away that we could install, even though it's really not gonna do anything of use. So I'm gonna come here to Gradle. I'm gonna refresh just to make sure all of our dependencies have been downloaded already. And then I'm gonna click this execute Gradle task icon here. And what I wanna do is I'm gonna say clean build shadow jar, okay? And we're gonna let that execute. And that's actually going to build our package. And so that's gonna go through and build the package. The output of this will be the jar that we need that we would ultimately install into our control room. So I'm gonna let this finish here. It's at the build right now. Cool, so it finished. Now, what we can do is if I go back out to that same directory, let's see, and I can go to, not that one, build, libs. This is the file that we just generated. So it's right now 3:15 at 5:35 p.m. for me. This is the jar file that just got generated when we did that build.gradle, or when we did that clean build shadow jar, right? This is the file that got created. I can now go to my control room and I could install this. We're not gonna do that as a part of this particular demo just because I wanted to make sure that we had this stuff installed that would support us actually doing a real package development in the future. But this is kind of like the prepare to get started kind of tutorial that we need to have in place so that when we actually do a real package, we can all have the stuff that we need already in place. So hopefully you're able to figure that out. Hopefully you're able to follow along with me. Again, I'm gonna include some notes in the video description so that you have some of that, those links. I'll include this clean build shadow jar command as well, so you have that. I'll also include some links to some references in case you wanna use a different IDE of different ways that you could build this same package, okay? My name is Micah Smith. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please be sure to like and subscribe for more of this Automation 360 content. Go be great.